Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to my talk on RMPD, a recursive midpoint displacement algorithm for path planning. It's a simple and novel idea. I hope you'll like it. Okay. So as for today's agenda, I'm going to start by talking about some motivating applications and then give an overview of the algorithm, move on to more details later, and wrap it up with some experimental results and conclusion. Okay. So the main motivation for our project is dormant fruit tree pruning. So pruning is a crucial process for fruit tree farmers to increase the yield of their orchard. And as of now, the majority of it is done by human labor. It's very labor intensive and costly. Therefore, we would like to consider automating this process with the robotic arm. And that's what's shown in the picture. So now our question of interest is which planning algorithm to use for the robotic arm. So as many of you may already know, prior to my work, there are mainly two categories of motion planner existing for robotic arm. So the first is sampling-based planners, for example, RRT and PRM. They are very time-efficient, robust. However, they can sometimes produce very jerky and extraneous paths that needs post-processing. And the second category is trajectory optimizers. For example, CHOMP, which stands for Covariant Hamiltonian Optimization for Motion Planning. They are known to produce very smooth and energy-efficient paths, but they are also known to have a high failure rate and slow in planning time. So now the question is, can we come up with something that combines the best traits of the two categories? So our attempted answer to this question is the algorithm of recursive middle point displacement. So it's a hybrid planner. It does obstacle avoidance by doing divide and conquer. And it iteratively updates the quality of the path using a resampling strategy. The details of this will become clearer later. So to give a step-by-step explanation of the algorithm, here we can see the diagram. So the first, oh no. No. Okay. So the input to the algorithm is always a straight line path. As we can see here, it's from S to G. So apparently this path is in collision with the obstacle. So what we want to do is to make a detour around it. The way we are doing it is by warping the path by displacing the middle point PM here to a new middle point PF that's collision free. And subsequently, we have two new subpasses from S to PF1 and from PF1 to Z. And since we are using a recursive logic, we apply the same RMPD logic on these two new subpasses. So for example, from S to PF1, since it's already collision free, the recursion stops there. And however, on the other hand, for the path from PF1 to Z, it is still in collision, therefore we apply the recursion goes deeper. As you can see by the animation, it's the same middle point displacement idea logic. So a final path is produced when there exists a collision-free path from the start to the goal. Okay, that's enough. So now I will talk about the algorithm in more details. First of all, what you see on the right is a pseudocode for the recursive diagram I just showed. So the interesting thing to notice here is that the choice for the new middle point is found by local sampling. So the sampling distribution we use here is a simple Gaussian sampling distribution with an adaptive standard deviation. So this strategy has been proven to be effective. You can definitely plan plan a obstacle-free path with it. But the problem comes when we are concerned about the path quality. For example, it often produces jerky and sharp turns in the path because of lack of regularization. Therefore, we would like to improve the quality of the path. And the way we do that is to introduce a new sampler, a cost-aware sampler. So the intuition, in place of the original naive Gaussian sampler. So the intuition behind this choice is that the choice for the middle point directly impacts the eventual path quality. Therefore, if we can choose a better middle point, we will end up with better paths. So in this cost-aware sampler, what it does is basically bias the sampling distribution toward regions where the points will yield better quality paths. So with this modification, we call our algorithm cost-aware recursive middle point displacement algorithm, CRMPD. So inside this cost-aware sampler, we adopt a repeat resampling strategy. So given a cost function f evaluated at a middle point that measures the local path quality, we iteratively update the sampling distribution of the middle point, therefore improving the quality of the path in every iteration. Specifically, in each iteration, we sample k new samples around the current middle point, evaluate their cost based on the cost function given to us, and then we assign them a weight that is inverse proportional to their cost. And then the new middle point is chosen to be the average of all the samples. Therefore, in the next iteration, when we are taking new samples, the sampling distribution is already biased toward a better region. So this process can be seen as an estimated gradient descent approach. It's called estimated gradient descent because we're essentially estimating the gradients by taking discrete samples. So, and eventually, I think this will converge to a local minimum. So the cost function. So the cost function really can be given arbitrarily, because it has no requirement on differentiability because we are evaluating at discrete points, nor convexity. And the cost function we have chosen is a simple combination of a clearance term and a smoothness term. So the clearance term is the sign distance of a point to its closest point of the opposite validity. It's very intuitive. It can be pre-calculated. And the smoothness term is an interesting term here. We choose it to be very simple, very intuitive. It is directly derived from the triangular inequality. And how you can interpret the smoothness term is that it serves as L1 regularization term that encourages smoother and shorter paths. I think that's all for the algorithm. I'll move on to the experimental section. So the CNRMPD and competing algorithms are implemented in C++, and we have used four benchmarks. First is a very simple bitmap benchmark. We have two rigid body motion planning problems, and then a pruning simulation. So to start things off, let's look at this very simple bitmap planning problems. So the result, which is normalized by the best performer here, shows that CRMPD was able to achieve optimal path length that's close to RRT star, where using the fewest collision checks. So this observation can be seen in the visualization shown below. On the left, you see RRT connect. It is very fast, but it often chooses passes that are in open space. As you can see, it's on the lower right. Therefore, their length is suboptimal. On the other hand, CRNPD is able to navigate through the middle narrow passage efficiently, while yielding a better length. So moving on to the rigid body motion planning problems. So it has 6 degrees of freedom, 3 translational, 3 rotational, and all the possible configurations form the special Euclidean 3 manifold. So we have chosen the environment such that narrow passages are present. One thing to notice is that sometimes doing weighted average thing in the cost-aware sampler may not be a simple task. So the solution to that is we simply choose a greedy version of the algorithm where we choose the best of the k instead of averaging them. So the result is surprisingly good. We outperform all the competitors in terms in nearly all the categories. Yeah. So And then the final benchmark is a very interesting benchmark. So So on the right, you see it's a sample pass planned by our planner. The benchmark consists of a 6 degrees of freedom robotic arm. There are 13 queries in total in this benchmark, where in each query, the end effector of this robot arm is tasked to move from the base of one branch to another, as suggested by the pink marker on the tree. So the interesting thing to see here is that this tree has a very spindly thin structure. Therefore, it presents a challenge for optimization based planners because it serves as a highly non-convex cost surface. So, and the result corresponds to the non-convex assumption. On one hand, we have stump, which stands for trajectory optimizer, stands for stochastic trajectory optimizer for motion planning. So it sacrifices time efficiency, but it was able to achieve the highest quality path. And note that it also suffers a very low success rate because of the non-convex surface. On the other hand, RT Connect is doing the exact opposite. It is very fast, but producing very bad quality paths. And our algorithm, that's when the advantage of CRNPD comes in. It has much more favorable standing in this trade-off than the competing algorithms. It was able to achieve 100% success rate with near optimum planning time and quality of the path. That's it for the benchmarks and conclusions. So basically, in this talk, we have proposed a basic logic for path planning or collision avoidance using divide and conquer. And then we further introduce a cost-aware modification to the logic, and in which the sampling distribution is iteratively biased toward better regions. And experiments suggest that our algorithm was able to achieve a more favorable trade-off in robustness and path and quality of the path, especially so in the presence of narrow passages. That's it for all questions. Thanks for making my life easier.
Testing. Hello. So you compared against sampling-based motion planners. Have you looked at a comparison with other types of motion planning, maybe for example, lattice-based motion planners, A-star, M-star, ARA-star, these kinds? And what do you expect in such a comparison?
So apparently we haven't done that. We could. I'm assuming it will behave, maybe the best, I think the expected outcome is that it will behave, if given the correct cost function, it can behave like RT star. It's eventually going to give in the best quality of the pass or whatever category because it's optimal plan, because they are optimal planners. But eventually what we are promoting here is the trade-off between optimality and time efficiency. So I still expect our planner to be more time efficient, but with less optimality. That's my expectation.
Okay, interesting.
Is it straightforward to add some constraint on the path, like I want to limit the curvature? Is it straightforward to do with your framework?
Yes, I think so, because so the flexibility here is the choice for the middle point, right? So if you can put constraints, if you can convert that constraint into a bias in the sampling distribution, I think any constraint that's translatable into a constraint for the middle point can be achieved by our algorithm. So that's my.
When you're comparing to the RRT algorithms, were you looking at having post-smoothed them or not? Because your cost function takes into account, internally takes into account smoothing, and you're using that as path quality. But for RRT, smoothing the paths first? Yeah.
So we have actually done experiments with and without smoothing. So the results I present, I mean, they both share the same trend, but what I present here is post-processing, after smoothing. So before and post-processing, they have the same trend, but what I show here is after post-processing. So yes, I have smoothed them, but with the same smoother. Everything is the same.